No man wants to die normally, isn't it? And let's say more than 99% of the men on the earth fear death. And you know, we know that where we have fear, the love of God is not perfected in that place. Because, you know, the goody of the gospel is that God brings you to a place where you have no more fear of anything. Where everything is unchangeable, where everything is in perfect peace and perfect stillness. When the seventh vial was opened in the book of Revelation, there was silence in heaven. Silence is eternity. When nothing changes, nothing can ever be taken away from you. What you have is what you have. Your glory is your glory. Okay, in this dimension that the Lord has brought us to, you do not lose a property, you do not gain a property. Everything is already yours. And that is the real world. No matter how things might look somehow in this world, in this present age, the evil age we call it. Don't forget, Paul over 2,000 years ago wrote that the days are evil. Okay, now the days are evil not because of the moral standards that are falling in comparison with the past, but the days are evil because this realm that you inhabit as a human being does not know God. It's the realm of the shadow of death. There is no knowledge of God in the world. Okay. Forget all those things you do on Sundays and all. There is no knowledge of God in this present world. Okay, so he has come with the revelation. The appointed time has come, and he has come and he has gathered us out of this world. He says, where I am is where you will be also. Where I am is the place of perfect stillness, unchangeable, no more fear. No more fear of plane crashes. Okay, no more fear of sudden death. You come to the place that you say, I am in the Lord and the Lord is in me and the Lord has not left me. I and the Father are one. It's a consciousness you attain to where you stand, you know, unshaken upon the highest peaks or the highest dimensions of existence. Jesus Christ says, in that day, nothing can touch you. In that day, in the day of your awakening back into God, the Father. Because in reality, the Father is the one manifesting himself in you. Okay, but you must awaken in you, in this consciousness, to realize the Father. Now the Father is eternal life. And the Father can never die. In the Father consciousness, you become aware. You start by hearing things. You start by hearing. We hear things. But if you allow that voice by faith to guide you into the things that you hear, you will experience it. You experience the bountiness and the beauty of the glory of God. It's a reality to be experienced. It's a reality to live. No more sorrow, no more pain. Yeah, we all had sorrow, isn't it? We all had pain, isn't it?
Yeah.
Somebody hurt us badly. Some of us, our parents did one or two things to us that hurt us. The mark remains with us. Some of us, our family members did things to us. And all those things remain in us, and from day to day you remember it, and you don't know how to come out of it. In the Father consciousness, you are delivered from that. The Father consciousness wipes away all tears and all pain, all bitter regrets. Who hasn't made mistakes? Foolish mistakes. Irresponsible mistakes. But in the Father consciousness, all sins are forgiven. The Lord heals my diseases. The Lord forgives my iniquities. It's the consciousness you have to awaken in the Lord to receive your healing. If you are waiting for somebody outside to forgive you, you will never feel it. You will keep waiting. You must arise from human sense. And when you arise from human sense, everything human is vanity. What you think hurt you does not exist. It's only a figment of your human imagination. It's the finite mind. You know, if you go out to the graves and you see the graves of the pharaohs and all that, you know they had their fights, their bitterness against each other. Some of them went to their early graves because of those warring among themselves. But you can see at the end of it all, it was all a waste of your energy. In the Father consciousness, I see only the Lord, because besides me, there is no other one. Can you exercise yourself in godliness to walk in the mind of the Father? That is the exercising yourself in godliness. That is the walking in the light. That is your fasting and your prayer. If you like, you fast day and night, don't eat water, don't drink water, don't eat food, it will not help you one bit. It will help your belly to go down, or it can give you some kind of spiritual hype initially, because your faith is actually based on what you believe. It can hype your faith to some extent, but it cannot give you eternal life. Your fasting and your prayer is to walk in the reality of the Father identity, which you are. Somebody said, but God the Father, yes, inscribed in you is the name and the nature of the Father God. You are the image and the likeness of God. You are actually creatures of his being. If you have seen me, you have seen the Father. That is who we are. You are not a drunkard. Okay, you are not, you know, whatever you people have labeled you to be in this world. You are actually the Father God. who has descended into this realm, made himself lower than angels, and descended into the lower parts of this earth to become a man, put on the nature, the lowly nature, the sinful nature of flesh. Flesh is already sin, because flesh is contrary to God. Flesh does not know God. Let me tell you what flesh is. Flesh is the carnal mind. And when you live by the carnal mind, I see this brother here, and I see him the way he is from the outer. I see this brother here, I see that brother. I see what we call idols, imaginations, graven images. These are the things now that become my gods. Even the impression of who I am becomes what? A graven image. And you know, you shall not have any graven image, make any graven image, or have other gods before me. You see, the Ten Commandments is disobeyed when you walk outside of your identity in God. You fulfill the Ten Commandments when you walk by the revelation of Christ that I am, who is one with God. That is the only way the Ten Commandments is fulfilled. Praise God.
Amen.
So let us understand what he's saying here. We have to, you know, realize who we are, meditate on it day and night. The meditation does not end one day. Okay, in this revelation, that means you have to lose all things. You have to suffer a loss of the vain things of this world. See, he says, those that have left all for my name's sake. Those that have left all. Now, your human things, you now leave that which is human to receive that which is spiritual from above, which is God. See, when the Spirit of God will come, he will give to you the things that appertain to my Father who is in heaven. Not to the things of men. God does not come to teach you information technology. He doesn't come to teach you how to become millionaire, how to become a millionaire. He's not aware, he's not into all those things. Now, along your physical human journey, yes, helps come, things come along the way, but all these are just things for the moment. Okay? For the occasion, the angel will materialize himself to become a physical human being, to appear in this world. He puts on a dress, isn't it? Have you wondered when the angels that visited Abraham, or the angel that visited Jacob, did they appear naked? Where did they get their clothes from? They take the clothes, put it on for the occasion. After all, they do what? They drop the clothes. They even drop that human, that physical identity. They drop it. It dissolves. And they go back into their identity. Do you realize that you are sons of God, equal to angels? You're actually celestial beings. You might appear in this physical world for 70 years, 80 years, 50 years, 40 years. What does it matter? The most important thing is how you rediscover this, you know, pearl of great price. That is the most important thing. Every other thing does not mean anything. You can live 100 years and not know that I and Father are one. You will still know eventually, but that is when you would have actually fulfilled you know, how do I put it? Got some kind of profit in this physical realm to realize this mystery of the ages and to walk in the glory of God. Great is the mystery of godliness. God is manifest in the flesh, seen by men and angels, preached in the world and taken back up into glory. You see, the invisible descends into the flesh, preaches the invisible to the world, and when he finishes, what? He returns back to the invisible. Okay, I'm going to read one scripture today, Job chapter 5 from verse 17, just 10 verses. Job chapter 5, I'm going to start from verse 17. I am reading from the King James Version, Job chapter 5, verse 17. Behold, happy is the man whom God correcteth. Therefore, despise not thou the chastening of the Almighty. He makes sore and binds up. He wounds and his hands heal. They make whole. Job chapter 5 from verse 17 upwards. I'm now in 19. He shall deliver thee in 6 troubles. Yes, in 7 no evil shall touch you. In famine he will redeem you from death, and in war from the power of the sword. He will hide you from the scourge of the tongue, and you will not be afraid when destruction comes. Okay? And you will laugh at destruction and famine, and you will not be afraid of the beast of the earth. Okay, you shall be at league with the stones of the field. Okay, and the beast of the field shall be at peace with you. Okay, and you shall know that the tabernacle is in peace. Okay, and you shall visit your tabernacle or your habitation and shall not sin. Okay. Thou shalt know also thy seed shall be great, and your offspring as the grass of the earth. Thou shalt come to thy grave in full age, like as a shock of corn cometh in its season. Lo, this we have searched it, so it is. Hear it, and know thou it is for thy good. Now, when you hear things like this today, I want you to go back and read it, read the Good News Version, read other versions. Let us spend time meditating on the Word of God. Let us not be distracted with things in this world. You know what I mean? At times, you have lots of distractions. And it's just evil communication. It's corruption that is out there. Nothing that is edifying. So, but these are the things that pertain to life and death. These are the things that are eternal, that really have value. That's why it's good to meditate on them. Happy is the man that God corrects. Now, what when we receive instructions from the Alpha and the Omega, when we receive instruction from God, the instruction is actually to build us up, or build up your faith, or the faith of the Son of God. Okay? To those that believe, he has given them power to become. So what he has come to do is to bring you up, raise you to become sons of God. You are already sons of God. But he has now come to awaken you to the reality. The sons of God are the ones who do, who say I, who do. They are the ones that if you see them, you've seen God. If you see the branch of a tree, what are you seeing? You are seeing the tree. If you taste the fruits of a of the branch on the branches, you are tasting the fruit of the tree. I and the Father are one. The branch and the tree are one. We are one indivisible body. God demonstrates this in the Nemorah, which is the symbolic Israeli or Jewish or Hebrew golden candlesticks, seven golden candlesticks. God had instructed Moses that the seven golden candlesticks should be made out of, beaten out, you know, by goldsmith, made out of one lump of gold. God warned them not to join pieces of gold together, but one lump of gold, that he should make that golden candlestick, seven golden candlesticks, out of one lump of gold. And we understand later that the seven golden candlesticks represent the Lord's body. That's the body of the Lord. The seven branches are the church. You are the church. You are the members of the body of Christ. You are one with God, indivisible. There is no time God exists without you, and there is no time you exist without God. Without you, there is no God. And without God, there is no you. Somebody laugh, but if you do exist, is there anything like God? Nothing. We are the ones who create God in our mind, because in reality, the God that you seek is actually I. That's the mystery of the ages. That is what Paul calls Christ in you. The mystery of the ages. Great men, religious people, great philosophists have traveled the length and the breadth of earth searching for knowledge. And many live this age never realizing that I am one indivisible body of God. But today he has given us ears to hear and eyes to see. So you rejoice at this revelation. Rejoice at this revelation and walk in it. So blessed are those whom the Lord corrects. He's instructing us now, correcting us. With this revelation. So that we can walk in the light and live. Okay? He said, make sore and bind it up. Okay? He wounded and he makes sore. Right now, in our humanity, we've all been wounded. We've all been broken up. The earth has been void. And none. Who has not felt the dryness, the famine, the pain in humanity? The sense of lack, the sense of nakedness. Who has not heard it in him, in his human experience? Even presidents, even people who were considered richest men on the face of the earth, they all felt the famine, they all felt the lack, they all felt the sense of nakedness, they all feared death. But there's a solution here. With the instruction of the Lord. Now the instruction of the Lord, God, let me tell you, God will never teach you any other thing but show you your true identity. Amen. all the rituals of church prayers, prayer methods, close your eyes, you clap your hands, you do all those things. They're just Hebraic religious doctrines that we have been indoctrinated into. The only thing that you ought to do is to know that I am God. From the rising of the sun, that's the dawning of the new day, they shall all know that I am. The awakening, everybody awakes to the reality of this incorporeal, incorruptible, immortal, divine life in God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
That is it. That is all that you need throughout all eternity. Not the dipping of water, dipping people into water, you know, or pouring of oil on people, or laying of physical hands, and all those things are just symbolic that people have inherited from the Hebrew religion, which is nothing but shadows of the things to come. They are parables. Somebody say, well, a brother wrote me from the south of Italy, and he told me, hey, but brother, people are being, Peter baptized people and the disciples baptized. I said, brother, when Paul came on the scene, they too were rattled by the teachings of Paul. They that were with the disciple with Jesus, they were rattled by the teachings of Paul, because Paul was higher, had a higher revelation. So the fact that the disciples dip people into water does not mean that it was actually of eternal value. They were walking in the light that they had
at that time.
Have you read the letter to the book of Hebrews, to the Hebrews? You see, Paul was the one who wrote the letter to the Hebrews. He was trying to admonish them to come higher from that Hebraic religion. You know, up to today, people are still holding on to all those things. Even governments. You know, people still believe. Look, every man has to submit himself to the Lord to live. Okay? If we do that, what happens is that he delivers us from all famine. He delivers us from death, from the scourge of the tongue. He says he comes to a time, six troubles, he delivers from six troubles. Six troubles means what? Man. Six is the number of man. Then he says, in the seventh, no evil will touch you. He says, the fear of death, you shall overcome. All is written here. These are secret coded words in the Bible. It's written here. You go back and read this chapter. He says, you shall laugh at death. You shall no more suffer famine. You shall laugh at famine and death. What is famine? Lack, sense of lack. The prodigal son came to a place where he says he was needful. Eh?
Okay.
Yes, he became impoverished. He could be a billionaire. He could have all the properties in the world and have everything and still be
impoverished.
Naked, miserable, blind in your humanity. But if we receive instruction from the Lord, we can never fail. Believe, don't doubt these words. Believe the word of the Lord. Believe when the Lord says that I and the Father Believe, you are not born. You are not lowly human beings. You are sons of the Almighty. You are actually one with the Father from eternity. And you are actually one with the Father presently. But you must awaken to it. When a man is asleep, it does not change who he is. He must simply awaken to realize it. When the people walk in the spirit and they see the one who is asleep, they know who he really is. But the one that is asleep might not be aware because he has lost all consciousness. Praise God. So the only way to abolish death forever, fear, oh death, where is thy sting? Oh death, where is thy victory? Oh sin, where is thy sting? The only thing is to receive, hear from the Lord, and walk in righteousness. Walking in righteousness means walking in the name of the Lord from heaven. It's a present reality. Unknowingly, lots of people are waiting for something to happen. Lots of people are waiting for a sign. Signs and wonders. They want something to happen, then they say, God has come. No. Hear. Mind how you
hear.
With the hearing comes your salvation forever. Hear and exercise yourself in what we hear. What you hear today. No more walk as the Gentile, the unbeliever, the ignorant man of the earth, but walk in the nature of the Lord from heaven. God bless you. Amen. Amen.